My name is Robina Courtin. I was born in Australia, in Melbourne. So I've been a Buddhist now for 40 years. And I think if I look back since I was a child, what drove me more than anything, I wanted happiness, we all want happiness. But what drove me was was the wish to understand things. I don't want to sound noble about it, but I always want to understand why and what. So I was a Catholic. I was in love with God. I went to Mass every day. I was in love with Our Lady and the saints. So that was really massive for me. But I was on the outside, very naughty, very rebellious, you know. By the time I was 19, I decided it was goodbye God, hello boys. That was the time, the 60s. Then I was in England, in London, the 60s. So I was ripe and ready for revolution and went in that kind of direction, you know. First radical left politics, then black politics, and then supporting, and then feminist politics. Always looking for a way to understand the world, but having the strong wish to understand suffering, I think. I never didn't say it like that. And then I did martial arts for a little bit. I gave up all the political thing. I wanted something internal again. And then, 40 years ago, literally this year actually, 40 years ago in Queens, I was back in Australia, and I saw this poster saying Lama Yeshe. I didn't know who he was, but I had time to do it, you know. So I went to this course. And I think by that point, it was, on the one side, it was a shock to me. I mean, I've been this radical political activist for 10 years, and it was an immense culture shock, you know, coming back to all these hippies and things. But I knew there was something there. I didn't understand a word. I thought Lama Zopa spoke for 1 month. I had no idea what he was talking about, this arcane 14th century stuff. But part of it, I knew there was something there, so I had to persevere, you know. And then I really liked when I heard that I'm the boss, in a sense, and I've got to check up on this stuff. So, you know, I stuck around, you know. I really liked Lama Yeshe. He came along in the evenings, and I sighed with relief because he seemed to make it sound so easy. And whenever he talked, I figured, wow, this makes sense, you know, this is possible. But I didn't understand the kind of the traditional way of presenting things. But I persevered, and the essence of it that I liked was the mind, understanding, learning to understand my mind. I'd never heard that before, you know. That was really powerful for my mind. And then because I'm kind of a fanatic, I'm 120% into whatever I do. I was a, you know, fanatic Catholic, then a fanatic hippie, then a fanatic communist, these things. So naturally, by the time I got to the Buddhists, bump into them, I'd already given up sex, actually. Well, I remember the moment, a couple of years before, when I said to myself, I don't want to give myself to one person, I want to give myself to everybody. But not just that. It was so clear for me, because I didn't want a home, I didn't want to share my bed with somebody. That was a shocking idea. I mean, it was like putting me in prison. I didn't want babies, and didn't want security. So it was a no-brainer for me that the pleasure that came in a relationship that came along with the misery didn't make it worth it, you know. So it was a no-brainer for me that wasn't what I wanted. And by the time I bumped into these Tibetans, Lama Yeshe, Lama Zopa, I'd already given up sex, given up drugs, given up alcohol, given up cigarettes. I hadn't quite given up marijuana yet. But essentially, I was moving in that direction anyway. So when I was 13 years old, I was on the floor in the kitchen in my mother's house begging her to let me be a nun, like Saint Therese of Lisieux, my great hero. So then 20 years later, I thought, oh, of course, this is the kind of nun I want to be. So it fell into place. It was natural next step. It was completely logical and reasonable for me. So then after meeting the lamas, I did this intensive 2-month course with them. And then a year later, I went to Koh Phan and became a nun.